Welcome back to Wild Tiny Farms, and this is a hive I want to get into today. And this is a hive I haven't featured on the video for just a little while since I put the Apivar strips on this hive. And as you guys remember, I put Apivar on this hive. I've done a whole bunch of things with this hive, and today I want to get into this hive again, and I want to see how they are building up. Today I just want to kind of talk a little bit about how my bees are building up, how they are doing, getting ready for winter, basically getting my hives ready for winter. This is going to be kind of like a little check to make sure that they're growing, you know, since I have not been feeding. That I also want to see if our goldenrod is doing anything for the brood pattern. We're going to move some of these frames over and get into the center and see what they are doing. I'm going to see if goldenrod is helping any, because I want to say this one thing, that you can't always trust goldenrod to do everything for you, if you guys know what I mean. And the goldenrod flow is a hit or miss each time. So therefore, it's probably good to go on and feed. I haven't started feeding, but I want to check this hive and see if they are doing okay, if their queen is doing all right, evaluate their queen, and overall show you guys how they're doing and how they're building up with honey stores. Because as a beekeeper, and in fall, we need to be doing that, so I want to show you guys what's going on in this hive. So this is not really a how-to, it's just, I want to show you guys what's going on in my apiary. Because a lot of you guys are wondering, hey Grayson, what's going on in yours? And that's what kind of videos I'm going to be starting to do more of, just kind of these update videos. I'm thinking I'm going to upload once every Sunday, maybe some during the week. But as you can see, there's a lot of beetles right there. We got honey, so that's looking good. That's all from goldenrod, I'm guessing, because I have not fed these bees just yet. So that is all goldenrod, I'm guessing, because they're capping it off. It could be a different kind of flower, but we have a lot of goldenrod blooming, so I think that's what they're mainly on, is the goldenrod. Well, like I said, you can't always trust it. It's just a hit or miss each time, and sometimes if you see that it's not going the way you need it to, the flow, if the bees are not pulling in as much as you want them to, you may have to start feeding your bees. So that's important as well. Let's see what's going on in this frame. Look at there, we got a pretty decent pattern here. We got eggs in there. I'm looking down in the cells, and I think this is new hatched bees. I can't really see. I think there's some larvae in there. But anyway, maybe the queen hasn't made her way over here, but we still have some brood on this side. Look at that beautiful brood pattern. I like that. This queen is doing a fantastic job on her laying, and same on this side. Look at that. A lot of young bees coming in, hatching out of the cells. See, there's a whole bunch of young bees on that frame. Ain't that pretty cool? So these young bees are going to help me go into winter. I need some young bees so then I can get through winter pretty decent. You know, I want a good packed cluster. That's how I am. You can do whatever you want to, because I can't tell you exactly what to do, but that's just what I like to do, and that's what I've always done. Let's move these frames over. I'm going to move these frames out of the way, and then I'll put them back the exact way I found them. It's 10 o'clock in the morning, I think, or it's actually 10:30. I want to get this video done earlier so I can upload it today, since today is Sunday. So I wanted to get out here and get this video done for you guys and see what they're doing. Like last week, we checked the bees. We checked the October bees. I didn't inspect this hive because I had other plans for this hive. I didn't really want to inspect it. But we're doing good so far. We got brood. And I think this hive is building up quite nicely. A lot of this brood is, of course, you know, already hatching, or they are, you know. Because I actually had to take a frame out of here, a beautiful brood pattern, a very beautiful brood frame. And I had to give it to another hive because the other hive doesn't have a good queen and I need to replace her. So I have queens on the way, and I'll do a video of that later on. I think we got eggs there, but look, this is a heavy frame of nectar, so that tells me that we are having goldenrod coming in, be a good bunch of it, and we also have a super on this hive, so, you know, we also have that so then the bees can put their honey in. I don't want just honey down here. I want some good honey in here. I want them to be heavy. But I want some frames of brew down here. That's important as well. That we have brewed, not just honey. So hopefully I'm going to see that this frame, maybe even this frame has a little bit more brood. And that would be good. But either way, they are still a decent pack, and these bees will probably last me the whole winter. But more bees, the merrier. Even though more bees mean that I'm going to have to feed more during winter if I have to. But I still got a lot of bees, and that makes me a little bit more comfortable about them going into winter. Of course, they can go down pretty fast, you know, like, you know, they can start perishing, their numbers can go down. That's why I'm treating with abivar. That's why I'm doing it, so I can keep my mites down. Well, look at this. This is another brood frame. It's kind of heavy, but look at all that larva. This is exactly what I wanted on this frame, is some good more brood. Let me try to show you guys this. Look at that. It's a beautiful brood, and before this, the brood didn't look exactly like this. Of course, as you can see, there's some opening where the queen hasn't laid, but that's just larva. That's a brood that hasn't hatched, and that's larva that they haven't capped yet. So the middle is where she already laid, and they just capped it a couple days ago. And the other larva is a larva that they're about to cap, and it's going to pupate in the cell, and then it will hatch out into an adult bee. Look at that beautiful brood frame on that side. That side is, there's eggs there. And the brood right here, that's hatching out as well. I see a baby bee right over here that is hatching. See that little baby bee right there that's hatching? That's pretty cool. Let's see now if we can find a queen. Is she on this frame? I don't see her yet. I'm gonna go around and see if you can see her. I don't see her yet. Let's be careful not to roll her or anything. I don't want to kill my queen. Of course, I got two queens on the way. I ordered one, but I ordered just two just in case if that one died in transit, or if I, once he got here, I had another problem in the apiary, I can already go ahead and quickly requeen a hive. I think this hive is good, though, for the time being. I'm going to set my frame right here. I'm going to kind of look for a second just to make sure I don't see the queen. Sun's coming out a little bit. Bees are foraging. A little cooler, but it's around 66, 65 degrees, so it's perfect time to start inspecting. All right, we're looking pretty good. Yep, I don't see any queen on this frame. And I scouted around on the camera. So if you saw it, look carefully. If you saw it and I didn't see it, or see the queen, let me know in the comments. But I really don't think, I don't see the queen with my own eyes. Put this frame right here. So yeah, I think these bees are building up on goldenrod. And you know, I really like that. I really like these bees. Ever since that goldenrod flow came in, I noticed that this hive was more packed. It was a little bit more nicer. Of course, right now, they're not as nice because it's kind of earlier and all the foragers are home. But for the time right now, I'm pretty surprised on how nice these bees are right now. But, you know, yesterday I was trying to do the same video, but in that hive, they did not like it. So I was not able to inspect that hive. But I decided I'd do this one because they are exceptionally nice bees. Right now, they're flying around me, but it is enough that I can handle this amount of bees. Sometimes, you know, if I'm inspecting a hive, right now, they're attacking the camera. I'm sure you guys can hear that. And the reason why I don't like inspecting mean hives on camera is because they make a lot of noise on the camera. And I hope that is not bothering y'all any, because I know they're bumping into the camera. At some point I'll get some better audio, but for the time being that should be fine. But come on, bees. Bees are all on the top of the frames. Now let me set it right here. Get these bees off my hands. egg. There we go. Look at that larva eggs side. That don't look good, but it's okay. I'll get a beetle blaster. I got a beetle blaster in the top deep, but I need to get one in the bottom deep. But overall, this frame's looking good. We got a brood that is hatching. It's looking good. See if I can put it in front of the camera. I see larva in there. That's a little bit of brood right there on the bottom. But that's a pretty good brood pattern. Look at that. I love that. Look at that. A decent sheet of brood. And in all the other sides of the frames that are not full that you see, that's just frames that the queen has laid in. But there's eggs, or it's hatching right now. Because some of these cells are hatching, if you guys, I mentioned that earlier, but they are hatching. A lot of these bees are already indeed hatching, which is very good for the queen to go back and lay more eggs. Goldenrod's really good for bees, you know, a good protein source in fall. You can't always trust it to build up your hives. You can't always trust it, and I'm looking at it today. And this is all from Goldenrod because I haven't fed them, and I'm pretty proud of what they're doing. But I'm still going to feed over winter, and I'm still probably going to feed them a bucket or two of a gallon sugar water. But I'm just letting these bees do a little bit more natural things. But and soon, I'm going to start feeding them. And that's just what I'm going to be doing. And another thing I really like about Goldenrod is it stimulates the queen very good to start laying eggs. The nectar in it and the pollen, and it just stimulates the queen to go on and lay more eggs and make better sheets of brood. I'm seeing that with all my hives, mostly, is that this goldenrod is helping them out with the nectar stores, / honey. They turn the nectar into honey, pollen, and it's helping the queen as well. Well, I don't see the queen. I don't think you guys saw the queen either, did you? If you did, let me know in the comments. But looking good on that side. Honey on the top right there. As you can see, they're storing honey on the top. It's looking very, very good progress on the bee so far. And, I'm trying to make sure that they're ready for winter. And, your queen's good evaluation. I've talked about evaluating queens before. All right, bees, there you go. So for the main title of the question, that yes, the bees are building up on goldenrod, and that's very good. But my message to everybody real quick is that you can't always trust the goldenrod flow. I can remember a couple goldenrod flows that were pretty decent. This one's decent as well, but right now I would just say don't always trust the goldenrod flow no matter where you're at, and be prepared that you may have to feed. That's important, to be prepared at. Alright, this goldenrod flow was presumed that it was gonna do very good, but actually it's just a dud. It didn't do good. Alright, this side there is nothing, which I kind of expected, but the other side, as I presumed, I didn't see the queen anywhere else, there's the queen right there. On the top, you see her right there in the middle, walking around for a long abdomen, laying eggs, doing what she needs to on that little honey space. I don't know what she's doing there, but she is doing very good. This is a pollen and nectar frame, so I don't know why she's right here. I don't see much brood, but I think she's probably looking for more places to lay because she already laid everywhere else. But it'll be all right, queen. You just got a little bit longer to wait, and more of these bees will start hatching. The bees will clean the cells, then the queen will come back after the bees that are cleaning the cells and lay in those cells. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright, bees, we're going to close you up. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. The bees are looking good. I wanted to show you guys how they're doing and how they're building up so far on the goldenrod flow and on the fall flow in general, because we got wildflowers blooming, we got things blooming, and they're still blooming. They're still out there. They're still goldenrod on the sides of the road that the bees are going to. And, you know, some people's goldenrods, like up north, they don't last this long, but our goldenrods will last till November, maybe even the end of November. Who knows? So I just can't trust it all the time. I just gotta be prepared that it could be that tomorrow the goldenrod flow will stop. And if that happens, and if all you're doing is focusing on the goldenrod flow going till November, then you're not gonna be prepared. So main thing to do is just do what I'm doing, and is inspecting your hives regularly and make sure that they have enough stores to go into honey. Down south, I do need a lot of honey, but down south it's a little bit different. I can't really explain it, but we're doing all right overall. And next year, we're gonna try to expand again. And a lot of people are asking me what are my goals next year. Oh, that wasn't good. What my goals are for next year. And I'm gonna say that my goals next year is to expand a little bit more. Because this year I expanded, but it didn't really go well. It just wasn't the best methods of splitting. So then next year, we'll be able to improve on that. And like I always say, I've talked about it before, that whenever you make mistakes, I've made mistakes this year about making not good splits. But next year, I can do it much better than I did this year. And Abivar's strips are on the hive. All right, let's check mark everything. So they got good honey stores. They got honey in the super. I'm about to put the super back on and close up this hive. They have about 4 frames of brood. The queen's laying. She looks good. And I got 2 new queens on the way. Late queens from a I think it was called Barnyard Bees. I've ordered from them before a lot. They're a popular company in Georgia. But anyway, I ordered some of those queens, late season queens, because like I said earlier in the video, I had never had that, not having a good queen. And I just don't trust the queen in that hive to do what she needs to do to keep the hive alive. So I went ahead and ordered some queens, and I ordered 2 just in case, like I said, maybe the queen died or got too cold and the other queen that survived. I put that queen that's still alive in the cage just for a precautionary state. And if both queens come pretty good, I'm going to take 1 queen and probably make a split. I may take 1 frame of brood from this hive and make a small 2 frames from this hive, or never have, and make a split. Or if once the queen gets here and I see, this hive or another one of my hives, the queen ain't doing good, then I can easily take the other queen, put her in the hive that the queen is failing in, and requeen. So that's my plan for requeening for the late year maybe splits, or maybe late year requeen the late year hives. And it ain't bad to do that, especially with mated queens, because you're taking a queen out, you're putting a new mated queen in. The only thing that you gotta worry about is if the hive rejects the queen, and that ain't gonna be a good scenario if that happens. But I hope that doesn't happen. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and close up this hive. I hope you guys enjoyed, and go ahead and smash the thumbs up button. We'll catch you guys on the next beekeeping video. Take care, everyone.